CTV family. Catch us live on your TV screens. CPT, where we be. 4 p.m. till 5 every week. CTV family. Catch us live on your TV screens. CPT, where we be. 4 p.m. till 5 every week.
Welcome back to the one and only. It's a Tuesday. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good to be with you. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good, and a happy Women's Month to all the phenomenal women out there. And I want you guys to tell us, who are your favorite woman, your most inspirational woman? Where can they hit us up at?
Absolutely, hit us up on our social media platforms. We are, of course, on Twitter and Instagram at @XA_Live. And on Facebook, you guys are following us at @XA_Live. #XA_Live. Make sure you tell us, who are your favorite women in the world? Who are your women that inspires you? Make sure you go to UQ. Make sure you go right now on WhatsApp, 074-65-00202.
And of course, if you've just tuned in, my name is Lauren Joffe, and we never fly alone. This is the wonderful Sinalo Jonas, and welcome back to your Tuesday edition. So we've got loads happening. One of the interviews we've got is with Mokone Mola. He is a nanoscience graduate. Can you believe that?
I want to speak more about him and with him.
What is nanoscience? But on top of that, he's going to be talking about a website that he's launched for bookings in salons. And on top of that, also, he's an author. So one of those multi-talented people. And on top of that, we are also going to be hearing from a first-generation graduate. That is Shanal Matheisen, 27 years old, and she's the founder of The F Word.
Well, that sounds amazing. And of course, on top of that, we'll be joined by the Misaniyata Foundation, which is a program that's all about equipping young people and, of course, making sure that they empower them through showcasing italian zabo and skills zabo. And of course, Nkosi and Lonwabo, who are fitness gurus, are in the building to show you some tips on how you can go about working on that summer body. David Yanchis, who is an incredible performer, is in the building. We're having a chat with him, and of course, he will be performing and closing off the show with an incredible performance.
And last but not least, on top of all of that, we have a brand new hamper that everybody can definitely stand a chance to win. So make sure you stay tuned to hear more about that phenomenal hamper. Don't go anywhere.
Part of the show where we take a look at what's currently happening in and around the social media. What are you guys currently discussing? We call this part of the show What's Trending. So Lauren, what's trending?
So there was a hijacking and a murder that happened in 2017. Do you remember the name? It was Dumi Silela.
I remember.
So now what's happened is, it was one of the Rhythm City actors, and there was 5 men involved in that hijacking. Now only are they still finishing up in court and trying to, you know, see what happens, seeing if they're remorseful. So the justice process is a long process.
Man, yep. I wish that they solved this case as quickly as possible. I know he was an incredible actor, yep, when his life was lost. So many were so sad.
And it turns out one of those men knew him because he visited his cousin often, and his cousin stayed in the same road.
So this was planned.
Yeah.
You know, oh man, that was such a very horrible loss for the entertainment industry. Well, on the other side, Muhale and Somizi on It again. We were saying we are tired of these two.
Remember? So much Somizi drama.
Remember, so many people were thinking that the rumors made by Muhale and Somizi are absolutely untrue. Mm. When Muhale said that Somizi is abusing him, there's jealousy, he's very uncomfortable with the friends that Muhale is making.
Yeah.
And of course, there's an open relationship claim that Muhale made. And this was reported by, of course, Sunday World. Well, in an interview that Muhale did with Sunday World, the reporter asked him, is Somizi uncomfortable with the friends that you have?
Mm.
Whom are some of these friends? Other figures in some of his friends? And Muhale said, absolutely yes. And Muhale was like, I just want to make a name for myself in the entertainment industry. And Somizi seems to be very jealous about that.
Sure.
Well, on the other side, last but not least, Umakati has a brand new song that she has produced. You know, she was in a heated argument with some of the greatest musicians in the country. But right now, she's released a brand new song that is currently making waves in Mzansi. In this song, she's featuring Prince Benza. And this was literally released in the 24th of July. And it's the number one on YouTube in the country at the moment. And she went on to say, I'm the first female artist in South Africa to reach 1 million views on YouTube within a week.
That is incredible. I heard it was even less than a week. I heard less, it was like five days.
How phenomenal.
It's just one of those things, you know, women sort of taking, you know, what do they say? When you hit a woman, you strike a rock.
Absolutely, you're striking a rock, and absolutely, she's doing great stuff. Let us know on social media, what do you think is trending? And we didn't mention right here, we have, of course, Onyxe at Cape Town TV, and of course, on all social media platforms. But right now, we're going to have a chat with an incredible human being.
Yes, I'm very excited. Don't go anywhere.
Lauren seems to be very, very excited about this interview.
Super excited.
Why are you so excited about this chat?
So I'm excited to interview you today because I know you are a multifaceted human being. You're an author, you're a nanoscience graduate, you're the designer and startup of a brand new website. And on top of that, you also are a fierce advocate for the LGBT community. So I'm super excited. I was so eager to start our interview. How are you feeling today?
I am so excited to be here and to have this conversation with you. I am so happy.
I'm glad you're happy. You're radiating that happy energy,
absolutely.
Right?
For those who don't know who you are, tell us a little bit about yourself. How was your upbringing?
Okay, I come from Limpopo. Then I did my undergrad and honors at University of Limpopo. Then I came to UWC to do master's, which I graduated cum laude. And I'm currently enrolled for PhD. Wow. Then besides academics, I am a Golden Key International Honor Society president. Mm-hmm. And I'm also involved with Masande, which is an organization that focuses on career development and youth mentorship for youth mentorship. And yes, I'm an author, I'm a designer, and obviously we're going to talk about Nifty Booking today.
The jack of all trades.
Definitely a jack of all trades. Before we hop on to the next thing, I wanted to ask you, what is nanoscience?
Okay, nanoscience is quite an interesting field of science. Mm. So we study materials at their nanoscale. So for example, you take gold. Gold is like yellow, but when you study it at its nanoscale, it changes to like red. There's a lot that is actually happening there.
Yeah.
So it becomes red or even purple, depending on what you're using to actually reduce it.
So actually it's one of those things where like if you look in a microscope, you can see the different things that an element is made up of.
An electron microscope, not a normal microscope.
Though.
Wow, that sounds very interesting.
People are out here doing things.
Doing great things. And I feel like so much more young people need to be exposed to such careers. So
definitely.
Like they've got so many different options rather than doing what we're told that we can only do.
Exactly.
But right now, something interesting about you that I love the most, that you're also an author and you've written your book that is titled Exposé, A Blessing in Disguise. Tell us about this incredible book.
Okay, Exposé, A Blessing in Disguise was inspired by, you know, I wanted to teach acceptance, first of all. Acceptance of oneself, accepting who you are, and then also accepting, like, other people, understanding that people are different, but we are all human.
Yeah.
And another thing is, I just wanted to show, from Gaviso's point of view, is the main character, the dire consequences that come with being rejected by family, especially your parents.
Yes.
As well as, you know, homophobic attacks, challenges that the LGBT community face on a daily basis. But then his mother had this secret that she kept for all these years, and then she revealed it and became a blessing in disguise for Gaviso.
Wow. Sounds really interesting.
Sounds really, really interesting. And then how do people get hold of this incredible book? Is it out? Is it on all digital platforms or is it on physical copies?
Currently, you can find it on Amazon. You can get it from me as well, and at Book Lounge Bookshop in Cape Town. And I'm still working on getting it to Exclusive Books and other bookshops.
Wow.
But you can actually get it from me.
So I want to hop on over because I know you're also very excited. Besides this phenomenal book that he's written, there's also a website. What is this website about? I know you're super excited about it. Tell me more.
Yes, it's Nifty Booking, so there you will find hair salon nail technicians or barber or makeup artist. So you just type in www.myniftybooking.org, and then when you get to the homepage, you'll find this listed, and then you just go to maybe, for example, hair salon, and then you click on book now, and then it will take you to a page where you'll find listed hair salons, and then you click on book now under this hair salon that you want, and then you're going to be taken to a booking page where you can now enter the details, date, whatever time you want to do your hair, and then you include your name, and then you click on schedule event or appointment, and then that's it. You've got your appointment set.
Talking about making life easy.
Right?
Especially for people like Lauren, who are always here and there, never have time actually to do it.
I need 48 hours in one day, not 24 hours.
Where do you ever find the time? I mean, like, you are doing a lot. And I'm thinking now, how many hours do you have a day? Because we only like, do you have an extra 5 hours?
We all have the same hours as Beyonce.
We do. I do have like 24 hours. It's all about, you know, just planning your day. I mean, and I find that writing stuff down helps. Yeah. So my day is quite filled. It's like a program, and I don't know how to put it, but then I have, okay, from this time to this time, I'll be busy with my studies. From this time, I'll be busy with whatever else that I'm doing.
A strict schedule.
You know, yes. Yeah. So that's just how I actually manage my day and how I manage to do all these things at once.
I think you're really taking advantage of the, you know, making the most of life.
Absolutely.
And of course, now that the website is up and running, I just want to know, how long did it take to execute
yes.
it? And of course, for it to start being coming into life?
Okay, so the website is quite interesting because I'm enrolled in a business course offered by Mashauri in collaboration with UWC. So that's how it came to be. So they're helping us to develop this idea into a business. So I'm still in the beginning stages. So now it's just we're offering only booking services, but then it's going to be something very big. And it started this year, actually, in I think April, somewhere there.
Wow, that sounds incredible. I feel like this is so inspiring that you are absolutely taking up space and of course making sure that you use most of your time doing incredible and positive things. You are such an inspiration, and today we chose you to have you in the show because you're absolutely an amazing person.
Well,
thank you so much.
Thank you for making me feel so special.
Where can people reach out to you?
On Facebook, I'm Gonimola. Twitter, I'm Gonimola. Instagram, I'm Gonimola. So I made it easy for them to
find. That is it for the gorgeous, gorgeous guest of today. Make sure that you guys stay tuned. CTV Family.